गुड आफ्टरनून ऑल। सो वेलकम यू ऑल आफ्टर द ब्रेक। सो वेलकम यू ऑल टू द सेशन 7 ऑफ द ऑनलाइन एफडीपी ऑन एआई। नाउ डॉक्टर संजय कुमार पांडा विल बी प्रेजेंटिंग द रेस्ट ऑफ द टॉपिक्स ऑन ऑप्टिमाइजेशन एल्गोरिथम्स। सो नाउ इट्स ओवर टू डॉक्टर
So,
संजय
we will
कुमार।
discuss prolog programming.
ओके ओके सर। सो
Okay.
नाउ लैब से session will take place, so please be attentive.
Okay, thank you very much, sir. So, at 4:30, we have a stress management session. So, in between, I will receive some call. Okay, I request all the participants, please excuse me for to receive the call, right? So, another announcement is that. Director IIITDM Kurnool, Andhra Pradesh, Professor Dr. DVLN Somayajulu, who is a senior most professor of NIT Warangal, has given consent to be the chief guest for our valedictory function on 26th evening 5. So I request all the participants to join that session and interact with him. So he has given his consent to be online on the valedictory function as a chief guest. Okay, so yesterday's this hands-on session, we have seen two programming. One program is already there inside that our demo folder of Prolog. And one simple program we have studied, that is sum of two number program, right? So today we will complete another two, three programs in this short period of time. So let me quickly introduce about the list, right? So list is nothing but a set of elements, right? For example, if you see, I have taken a list. Okay, the list is having four elements: A, comma B, comma C, comma D. Right? So the syntax, if you see, for a list is nothing but head followed by the rest of the list. So generally, if you are writing a list, first element is treated as head, rest elements are treated as your rest of the list, or you can say trailer, right? So initially we will take A, B, C, D. Okay, A is your header, B, C, D is the rest of the list. Then B, C, D will pass to some function. Okay, it will pass B, C, and D to some other function. So whenever that function will receive it, so B is treated as our header list, and C, D is the rest of the list, right? So that you will see whenever we are going for some programming. For example, if you see ABCD case, right? Initially, the list is ABCD. A is the header, right? Then BCD. So whenever I pass BCD, B is the header, CD is the rest list. When I pass CD, C is the header, D is the list. So this is called as your list concept. And predicate already you have seen, right? We are writing elephant Mary, or we are writing Ram is taller than the Lakshman, right? So these are called as your predicate, or in the last class I told you, these are called as our fact, okay? But everything should be end with a dot, okay? Each and every statement is end with a dot mark. Fact, you know, I'm skipping. Rule, you know, I'm skipping. Okay. Okay. Now come to this example. So all of you, please write this program. So let me show this program in the right side. My screen is visible, right? My screen and
Yes,
voice
sir.
is locked up.
Visible.
Okay. Yes. Okay, let me create a new file. Let the file name is OP, OP for operator, right? And I'm storing in the desktop, right? Then the file will open. Then I am copying this code, whatever there in this particular slide. I'm writing elephant and pet. Next, elephant, Mary, elephant, joy. Animal red is true if elephant is red. first three is nothing but our fact. Now I am writing one rule. Red is an animal. If you know only red is an elephant, right? Similarly, I am writing animal Mary is true. The elephant Mary is true. Right. Next is animal Joy is true if and only elephant Joy is true. So this is my program. So after writing this program, we have to compile it. You check that markdown. So all of you please write. I'm giving you 1 minute time. Elephant Fred, elephant Mary, elephant Joy. Then these three are the fact, and last three are the rule. That is, Fred is an animal if Fred is an elephant. Mary is an animal if Mary is an elephant. And Joy is an animal if Joy is an elephant. So I have written this program to only tell you how the query works. I hope you have written. Okay, let me close it. See, here I cannot write the command. If I'll write any command here, I will get an error, because in the above you see it is written SWI hyphen prolog AMD64 multi-threaded version 7.6.4. You should not run in this particular position. So now it is showing op.pl. It is available in the desktop folder, right? So now I'm writing my query is nothing but animal Fred, comma, animal Mary, comma, animal Joy. So it is showing true, right? So I have asked three queries by asking that Fred is an animal or not, Mary is an animal or not, or Joy is animal or not. Three different queries I have posted. So it returns true. So let us see how this process is carried out. So initially what it will do, it will search animal Fred, right? Animal Fred is detected here, okay? It will be replaced by elephant Fred, right? As you know, if animal Fred is true, then elephant Fred is also true, right? So I am replacing this animal Fred by this animal Fred, I am replacing by elephant Fred. And rest of the queries I will take as is, because my first query is not solved. So this query will start from the left side towards the right side. So once element Fred I will get from this particular statement, I am checking whether element Fred is a fact or not. Okay, so this is a rule. In the rule I am getting element Fred. Now I am checking whether element Fred is true or not. Yes, element Fred is there in our knowledge base, so it will be removed. Yes, you know that anything is multiplied by 1 is the result is the same thing. Similarly, once you found something in your database, if it is true, that is removed. So after removing this element Fred from the knowledge base, we have left with animal Mary and animal Joy. Again, animal Mary is equivalent to element Mary, right? So animal Mary can be replaced by elephant Mary, right? And elephant Mary is already there in the knowledge base, so it is also true, right? So it will be removed from the knowledge base. Last one is animal Joy. Okay, animal Joy is nothing but the elephant. Sorry, animal Joy is animal Joy can be replaced by elephant Joy, and elephant Joy is also true, right? So it is completed here, and finally the query is completed. As all things are successful, it is returning true. Okay, now I will tell you some of the program directly. See this example. Here I have taken, this is your prolog program, okay? I have written ant eater Fred. Fred is an ant eater. Fred is an animal if Fred is an elephant. Fred is an animal if Fred is an ant eater. So now I am asking a question animal fred. So animal fred, where is it? It is here, it is also here. So initially animal fred, okay, whenever you ask prolog interpreter animal fred, it will search animal fred. Animal fred will be detected in two positions. So if you take the first position, it will replace animal fred by elephant fred, right? But elephant fred is not there in the database. If you see, this element fred is not available. This is not a fact. I have not written any statement here. If I write elephant fred, then it is true. But elephant fred is not there in our knowledge base, right? As it is not there in our knowledge base, it will return fail backtrack. So it will backtrack from this particular rule. So it will check, is there any other animal fred is there? Yes, it is. Animal fred is available here. Yes, animal fred is available here. If it is true, then anteater fred is true. So and it is replacing now animal fred with anteater fred. As it is true, it is available in the knowledge base. Now there is an empty query. Query is completed, so it will return true. So in this process, the prolog compiler works. Now all of you please write this program. So this is a graph problem. Whatever we discussed in informed search and non-informed search. So some of the program you can implement using this one. All of you please write this program. So let me create a new file, right? And in that new file, let me give the name as XYZ, right? I'm saving in my desktop. So it is open. Now I'm typing P1. P1 is a name of a node. In morning you have seen CT we have considered as a node. Now I am representing P1, A1, B1 as node. P1 is true if A1 is also true. But P1 is true means A1 is automatically true. Then P1, see in this particular graph, I hope this graph is visible, right? This graph is visible, right? Can anybody answer?
Yes, sir, it is visible.
Yes. Okay. So see, based upon this link, P1 is connected to A1. That's why I'm writing P1. If it is true, then A1 is also true. Similarly, P1 to B1. So I'll write what? P1. I'll write P1. Then it is B1. Next, I can write A1. Is connected to C1. So I am representing each and every link as a rule. Next is C1. C1 is connected to B1. And C1 is also connected to D2. Okay, this completes my left subtree. Let me go to the right subtree. Right subtree, we have B1 is E1 and another is only D3. All of you please write. Another statement we are writing is a fact, P1 is also true. Okay. So a tree is given to you, okay, and some basic fact is given to you. Here the fact is nothing but D3 is true, E1 is true, and every other things are represented in the form of rule. So what I will do, I will check if I am there in the P1 node, whether I can reach to a goal node or not. Like you have to, in morning you have seen when you expand Arad, you are getting three cities, that is S, T and Z, right? So just I am asking, whenever I am there in A or I am S or in T or TZ, whether I can reach to a particular solution or not. That is the use of this particular program. So if anybody is reached to E1 or D3, okay, then that statement is true, right? You will get true. For example, let me take P1. If P1 is there, from P1 you can take D1. And if P1 is true, then you can derive B1. If B1 is true, then E1 you can derive, and E1 is a fact. As E1 is a fact, then it will return true. But if I write D1, so there is no rule with D1. D1 is there, C1 is equal to D1, right? But nowhere it is written that D1 is true. That's why if you type D1, you will get the result false. So let me run this and show you. I hope you have written this program. So this is op.pl. I should not run here. So let me close and open this XYZ. I have given name XYZ. I am asking P1 whether if I am present in P1, whether I can reach to my goal node E1 or D3 or not. It is saying yes. Okay. But whenever I am there in the D1, I am asking whether I can reach to the solution. No. Let me check for A1, what it is showing. A1 also it is true, false, right? If you are present in A1, you can go to C1. If you are C1, then you can go for D1 or D2. But D1, D2 is not present in your knowledge base. As it is not in the present in the knowledge base, your search is failed. So it will return false. Now, let us do a small change in this program. Any doubt in this program? Please ask. Why A1 is false? Where is A1? A1 is false because if you see in our knowledge base, let me write edit so that you can see. If you see in our knowledge base, okay, we have written A1 is equal to C1. So whenever you are asking a query about A1, it will go to C1. Once it will reach to C1, it will go to D1. But D1 is not true. D1 is here as a rule. But D3 and E1 as a fact. So as if I write D1 here, it means D1 is a fact, so it will return true. So it is failed. Once it is failed, it will go to the next occurrence, that is C1 to D2. Again, D2 is also not a fact, so it will return false. Okay, I hope you don't have any doubt. So let me tell you, you simply little bit modify this program. Just I'm showing another slide. So now I have added, I have added a link here. If you compare my previous slide and this slide, see here B1 is not connected to D3, but in the next slide, I have connected B1 to D3. The same program you have to write, only you have to add this path. So if I want to add this path, what I will do? So somewhere I have to write B1 is now connected to D3. B1 is now connected to D3. Right? Then I am compiling my program. Make this done. Right? Only this statement I have added. Only this last statement please add. Those who have completed the first program, please add B1:D3. Okay, then you compile it. Now I am asking here in the same program. Asking P1 is true or not. It is showing true. So I am saying how many solutions you are finding. So if I put enter, then what happened? It will terminate. I told you in yesterday's class, if you put enter, then it will terminate. If you put semicolon or tab, so it will say if multiple solutions are exist, then it will return multiple solutions. So it is saying P1 is true because there are two base clocks. E1 is also true, which is there, which is a fact. Okay, D3 is also true because of these two things. P1 is also true, right? Similarly, let me write B1. Whether B1 is true or not, if you say B1, B1 also true for two times because B1 is also connected to E1, but B1 also connected to D3, right? But if I write C1, what it will return? C1, it will return false because D, neither D1 or D2, which is connected to C1, is a fact in our knowledge base. So all of you please complete. I'm giving another 2 minutes time. What we are getting, C1 is false. C1 of Y. So this C1 is false. Yes, obviously C1 is false because here C1 is connected to D1. C1 is also connected to D2. Neither D1, D2 is true or is a established as a fact, right? Here E1 is a fact, D3 is a fact, but we have not written D1, D2 as a fact. So it is false. Okay, let me proceed further. So this is same as the previous one, so I am skipping. So now, so this is another graph problem, right? This is another graph problem. Okay, so let me create another file, new. Then let me write graph. What is the file name? Okay. Then I am doing edge of a comma b. Okay, so if you see this graph, there is a edge between a to b, that is true, right? This program is the objective of this program to find a particular path. Path means, for example, let a is Hyderabad, right? B is Nagpur, D is Bhopal, E is New Delhi. So I am asking whether there is a path exist between A to E. In the morning session also, few participants asked about directed graph and undirected graph. So here, this is a directed graph because there is an edge. You can come A to B. A to B is possible, but B to A is not possible. Similarly, A to C is possible, but C to A is not possible. So A is AB, okay? Then edge, A edge exists between B comma D. Okay, then another edge exists between D comma E. Okay, next edge is established between A and C. So these are my facts. Okay, but I have to establish some rule. What is the rule? The rule says a path is also an edge. If I write whether there is a path exists between A to B, that is same as AB, right? A path, that is the shortest path you can say in the graph. So path of x comma y, sorry, path of x comma y, if user input x y is variable. So I have seen a few people are writing x y in small letter. So I request all of you to write in the capital letter because this x y is a variable and small is a constant. So a is of x comma y, right? Similarly, path of x, y is also true if there is a path exists between x and z, and there is a edge exists between z to y. I'll tell you this meaning. Please try it first. See, in this graph, I got there is a path from A to B. There is a edge between A to B. There is a path between B to D. There is a path from D to E, and there is a path from A to C, or edge between C. Okay, that's why I'm saying if somebody asked question whether there is a path exist between A to B or not, so we will convert that question to edge of AB, right? See here. Suppose somebody will ask path of a comma b. So every edge is a path. Okay, a comma b, right? Okay, so a I will replace by x, b I will replace by y. Okay, what I will result? If you replace there, it is nothing but edge of x y. Or in the usual term, I can say edge of a comma b. If edge of a comma b is exist here as a fact, as it is exist as a fact, what I'll do? I'll return true. Okay. So this is every edge is considered as a path. Now user is asking a question that is there any path exist in between a to d? A and d is not directly connected. A is connected to D through B. So what I'll do? The second rule will work here. What the second rule will do? It will do two things. So this comma indicates end. It says that you have to take path of what? X is what? X is your A. Z. Z is nothing but your B. And there is a edge exist between B to D. That's why this clause returns there is a path exist between A to D. Okay, again this path to AB, if you put here, then it will be derived as edge of A comma B, right? And edge of A comma B is true here. Edge of B comma D is true here. So as both conditions are true, it is a AND logic, right? AND get. Both conditions are true, then only the output is true, right? So here you will get your answer is true. So I hope you have written this program. Let me compile it and close the file. So the file name is, I have written some path or sorry graph. So let me check. You check this graph. Let me ask a question here. Path of A comma E exist or not? What it is saying? True. Okay, there is an error. Path of A comma E. Yes, exists. It is true, right? And it is the only solution, right? There is a path exist. There is a single path exist between A to E. If there is more than one path is there, you will get two times true. So let me write whether there is a path exist between C comma A. There is a path exist between A to C, but there is no path exist between C to A, or there is no edge. So when you write it, what it is showing? Out of local start means it is not true. Okay, let me trace it. See what is the result, why it is coming like this. Trace dot. Okay, what to trace? Trace the path of C comma A. It is calling the path. Okay, then calling the path, it is failed. You want to it will redo. It is checking with other edges, whatever there in the knowledge base. Checking all the possibilities. Okay, so many possibilities are there. It is checking, and whatever the start limit is there, that is over. That's why it is showing an error. Okay, all the possible things it is checking, that's why we are identifying an error here. Okay. So next this course you can, if it is a undirected graph, you can use these two statement. If you add these two statement there in your program, you will get a undirected graph. So you please try this thing in your leisure time. I'll cover some important part, some important program. Okay, this family program we already discussed, right? No, we likes program we discussed, right? So all of you please write this program. This is a family program. Okay, please write the program, don't write the comment lines. So male Ram is a fact, so Ram is a male person, right? Then I am writing Dasaratha is also a male. Okay, please don't that means please type the spelling very carefully. Okay, otherwise you will get an error. Next I am saying female is Kaushalya. And I'm introducing another thing, parent. Dasarath is parent of Ram. Then Kaushalya is also the parent of Ram. Okay, these are the facts, right? Now I'm writing some rules. Rule says that I'll claim father is XY, means X is the father of Y if and only if. What is the condition? X is the father of Y. The condition is that father is also a parent, right? So X should be parent of Y and X should be a male person. Try to understand what I have written. Father XY means X is a father of Y if and only if X is a parent of Y and X is a male person, then only it is true. Similarly, I can write mother of XY, X is the mother of Y if and only if X is also parent of Y and but we should be the female parent of, we should be a female person. Okay, see first fives are fact, then we are writing some rule. What we are writing in the rule? Father XY is true if and only if X is a parent of X and X is a male person, then only it is father. Okay, and X is the mother of Y if it is a, X is a parent as well as it is female. So that parent is a female member. So let me compile. So the make is done. Now I am writing some query in the family program. What is my family program? Here I have set. Okay. Let me go to my C drive. Open files. Maybe I have saved there. So I clear the name. Okay, now here. Documents. Okay, let me check again. It is there in the project folder. So let me ask some question here, right? So I'm asking, who is the father of Ram? What is saying Dasarath, right? So I pressed the semicolon, that's why it is saying false. Okay, then I'm asking, who is the mother of Ram? Kaushalya, right? Then, interestingly, now I am asking, who is the father of whom, right? So it is saying, Dasarath is the father of Ram, and there is a false. So this is the interesting part in this program. Okay, so I am asking the question here, who is father of whom? So prologue is having an interpreter. That interpreter is having such power. Who can say finally conclude that who is the father of whom? Because here I have already established the fact that father of X Y is nothing but X is the parent of Y and X should be a man, right? Similarly, you can ask who is the mother of whom. It is showing Kaushalya is the mother of Ram. Okay, any doubt you please post in the chat window. Yes, it is transitive, it is true, right? A to B, B to C, it is A to C. That is a transitive relationship, it is true. Which one is no? Roshni, which one is no? After make is done, you make sure that whenever you are writing some program in prolog, make sure that the program appears here in the top part. You see that program file name should be there. If program file name is not there, you will not get the output. Few people have sent me yesterday, sent me the snapshots in which I have seen it. The top part, if you see, it is showing Swai Prolog AMD 64 multi-threaded version 7.6.4. Anything you write here, you will not get any output. And all of you, please install 32-bit. If you have not installed, if you are unable to run the program, you install 32-bit. Okay, irrespective of your 32-bit, 64-bit operating system. And please write this X and Y value in the program in capital letter, because these are variable. Something you write in the small letter is a constant. Let me see, is there any question? Want to get the thing top. Code is here. Code is here. Code is there. Please avoid that comment line. Program is running perfectly now. Let me see some of the. I am not able to get the output. You sir, please check. Dr. Yojendra sir, please check. My program is incomplete. Please show the code again. The code is present here. There are two rules. Okay, let me show you here also. These two rules, one is X is a father of Y if X is a male parent of Y. That we have written, X is a parent of Y, X is a male person. X is mother of Y if X is a female parent of Y, that we have represented by parent XY comma female X. actually is no source to me after all that. In the 64 bit also, we can consult command to run the code. No, actually, there is a, yes, it is true, 64 bit you can install, but the main problem is that if you go through the prolog manual, okay, if you go inside that manual, it is written there is some stack size, okay, that stack size, if it is, if you having a less processor or less RAM, okay, so what will happen? So the stack size is exceeded, so you are not getting, you are getting some error. So that's why they recommended that you install 32 bit. And it is working fine and it is good. Okay, rest slide, you please go through it. I have written all the program with their output, right? All the programs with their step-by-step process I have written. I have already shared this slide. You may have seen.